Yes, we must continue. I would say good morning, good afternoon, good evening, good night to some of you, depending on your time zone. This is Radio Biafra Extra for the avoidance of doubt, a live broadcast on this very fateful day, the 13th day of the month of June, the year of Chukwukike Abiodun 2019. We are streaming live through Radio Biafra London, being anchored by the deputy leader of the indigenous people of Biafra, Mazi Uche Okafor. He is from Abateti is in Anambra, and Anambra State is Biafra land. He is the one who have assured us that he will not allow the heart of this project to see corruption. Whenever we use this word, most of you do not understand. But for the avoidance of doubt in an empire of corruption, in a corrupt entity like Nigeria, it's almost impossible. It's almost unbelievable that a man could stand up and say, I will not be corrupted. It's just like the fish saying, I will not swim. It's impossible. But Mazi Uche Okafor made this possible. He said, I will not allow the heart of this project to see corruption. And I think you should go and deal with that. And to this moment, he's been standing by it. We've never been proud of any Biafrans as much as we are proud of him. Believe me, we're still looking for what to qualify him. When I look at him every day, I remember something or something comes to my mind. And that is one Igbo song that say, Unya pakwale inya kanodu, mordendu, mongurangu. Unya pakwale idia kanodu, mordendu, mongurangu. The gentility of a tiger is not a sign of cowardice for the avoidance of doubt. As which him, Okafor remain our deputy. Trusted, tested, tried, and sanctified. Mas which Okafor remain that. Of course, he's standing in a deputizing capacity on behalf of our supreme leader. Our supreme leader is Mazenand Yoku Kano, the one that commands the loyalty of the Biafran people. Understand, we are not here to sell personality. We are here to tell you the truth. We are here to appeal to your conscience so you will wake up and defuse yourself from the matrix. One man speak for us. His name is Mazenand Kano. He is from Afali Beku. Afali Beku is in Umuahia. Umuahia is in Abia State. And Abia State is Biafra land. We were beaten down to stupor. We were beaten down to Kuma. Nobody can stand up and speak for the interest of the Biafran people. Everybody are just busy looking for alert until he came. And now you know. Have you seen the light? Of course, as we speak, he's stalling the continent of America. You know, the supposedly terrorist organization. Touring everywhere in the world. Look at how shameless Nigerian can be. You think there are not genuine men and women alive today? Britain can choose to steal the resources in Biafra land and impoverish us. That does not mean all British people are bad people. There are British people with the heart of angel. But those devil, those children of Satan in Britain, they will understand that they have a people to deal with. When we come, we talk about America. Yeah, man, you're going to move on, man. You're good, man. You're doing well, man. You think everybody in America is good? But then we are not after the good men and women. We are not after conscientious people. Every evil man on the face of this planet who think they can undo us as a people in order to have their way, they just in. Let me not use foul language anyway. But we must continue. We must continue. And I remain George Onyibe. I am from Abo. Abo is in Delta State. And Delta State is Biafra land. I'm looking for a way to serve Biafra. But believe me, I've not served Biafra. Because we have made vow with the heavens that we will never sleep with those who murdered our father and our mothers and raped our sisters and our wife before our prison. We will never sleep under the same heaven with them. We have vowed to the Almighty Creator. We will not rest until Nigeria is obliterated. And that is why if I sit back, I watch them. They are jumping up and down. They are warriors. Well, enjoy it while you have the time. For you have no idea what is coming. Have we not confronted you, Almighty Creator? Have we not said to you that if in your infinite wisdom, that the sacrifice you will decide is for us to lay down our life, that you might let us go? Have we not said to you that we will gladly lay down our life? That exactly we have done. But I won't move forward until I acknowledge him. Anyina jage mau imakwa nezioku ne maramai ihunanya ninake ubiomake ujuru manya dadimo imakwa ningwe gimbangwe o todi unye dekake ibu wafano mega anyini ne nasina edemau. Unye de kage. Unye de kage. Unye de kadadi. Chineke. Odi unye de kage. Ede manu tutwe. Ede mani hiye. Ikwisiri to kwa subi. Chineke. Odi unye de kade. If you think I'm religious, You are hallucinating. I'm not. It is in my DNA. We worship Chukwuka Kabiama without apology. And so if you are Igbo man, I'm not talking about the whole Biafra. If you are Igbo extraction of Biafra, you are behaving like monkey and babu. I pity you. Because you never know who you are. Inferiority complex has destroyed you. Our sister from Urobu has made it clear to you. Inferiority complex. They tell you, you are baby ritual. No, how do they use it? You are baby fatre, and you endorse it. Oh, no, Igbos are forerunner, you endorse it. Igbo are cooking pusher, you agree. Igbo don't love themselves, you believe. Look at what IPOB have done. Look at where IPOB have taken you to. Today, now, ritualist, Yoruba. Terrorist, Awusa. Forerunner, Yoruba. Hopelessness, Awusa. You can go on and on and on. I don't see Igbo man on the list any longer. When exactly are you going to be grateful? We will not rest until they are obliterated. All the enemy of our people who have condemned a whole nation, a generation of a people because of the sin of one man, then your generation will be destroyed for your atrocity. Chukwo idemao, Jehovah edema, Olilanyande so edemao, Omakai sebi waleo, ne edema, nezi chineke moho, na yekele u, bwini, ne anyane lu wame, na yekele u, bwini, ne, ima kwa nase na nine memao, eze mase na nena gwolia u, Daddy Masina Nine Yikeo Chimbo Webiaro Burwe Zyoku Chukwe de Mao Edema Aba Waba We Edema Ulila Nyande So Edema Chimbo Unyengwe Me Edema O Imakwane Ogele Lanyane Ni gwe o dadi o e ba ho e na chiachi o e we nfo chuku ne de ma o e ze unye nwe e de ma o oh e de ma o oh e de ma o oh e de ma e ze Yenwe e de mao anyina jage mao imakwa nezioku ni maramai ihunanya enenage ubiomage ujuranyanya dadio ingwe gembangwe o odi unye dikage ibu wafanu miga anyinini nasina Edemao. You see, I've never heard anybody say, George Onyibe is always worshipping Chukwuka Kabiama. George Onyibe is always worshipping Chukwuka Kabiama. We don't like it. But when I tell you, get out there, animal,
Hey, come pack your motto.
Of course, this is Radio Biafra Israel and Reverend George Onyibe reaching you live and direct from Urugudu, Iorugudu, Urugudu, Wunyabo Yakanwo, Urugudu Yakanori, Timbu Nireti, Urugudu Kanori, Yoro Nireti, and Chonunu Tehuna, no Telo Nonahema, Umano Chone, Tunu Tehuna, and Yadonu Tishi, and Yadonu Ekodo, Tehuna Nareti fellow, while young Wakuku Woku was song. But we must continue. If you don't understand the grammar I just released, I can't help you anyway. We'll move ahead this evening to our topic, which is simple. We know we will always come, and our target is that our people will awaken to their responsibility according to Amadu Bello. Our topic this evening is simply, history is about to repeat itself. History is about to repeat itself. There are certain things they say, don't say it, don't say it, don't do it, don't do it, don't leave it that way. No, we will say it, we will do it, we will never leave it that way. Who told you? History is about to repeat itself, and all of you are watching it, all of you are looking at it. Oh God, help your people. Help your people. No, don't see it, don't see it, don't talk about it. But are you not seeing the handwriting on the wall? Honestly, are you kidding me? Are you telling me you are not seeing it? And some people say, you know, all this thing Radio Biafra saying, it can never happen. It's not possible. It can't happen. You have been saying this all this while. It can never happen. Buhari divided Nigeria. 97-5%. It can never happen, but it's there before your eye. Buhari excluded Igbo from security. Would you say apparatus or architecture of the nation? Did I say nation of the zoo called Nigeria? It can never happen. It can never happen. It's a propaganda. Buhari appointed his Islamic brother to head every security and military paramilitary bodies in the zoo called Nigeria. No, it can never happen. It's a propaganda. Yes, it can never happen. Buhari took off the UK for months. He's in UK for months. It can never happen. The alliance is a propaganda. Yes, it can never happen. Buhari removed the chief of justice of Nigeria and put a Sharia lawyer there. No, it can never happen. Yeah, it can never happen. It's a propaganda. DSS attack judges at night. It can never happen. Oh, it's a propaganda. Yes, it can never happen. Buhari approved the release of Boko Haram fighters and incorporate them into Nigerian army and welcome them with red carpet. No, it can never happen. It can never happen. It's a propaganda. Don't mind that, POB. Yes, it can never happen. Buhari integrated Boko Haram into Nigerian military fighter. No, it can never happen. It's a propaganda. Of course, Buhari gave billions of naira to Fulani herdsmen. It can never happen. If it can never happen. Of course, it will not happen. Buhari have opened a radio station for Fulani herdsmen. No, it's a lie. It can never happen. It can never happen. They have told you there will be no crossover night. Hey, it can never happen. It can never happen. It can never happen. It's surround sound east with hundreds of military checkpoint. It can never happen. It can never happen. He have never arrested nor retired any one from 1,000 murderers of his people. It can never happen. It can never happen. All things that are happening that have never happened have happened, and nothing will happen. Oh, you remove good luck, we will burn Nigeria down. Good luck have been removed. You did not reinstate Onoje, we will burn Nigeria down. He have been reinstated, he will not be reinstated. We will kill you if you invade what is that criminal name? What is his name? This man that carry water for our sir. Oh my God. Why? Is it Tony Clark or Black? What is his name? You know, when you are too evil, your name cannot be remembered. Edwin Clark. No, you invade Edwin Clark's house. If you don't apologize, it can never happen. It has happened. We are declaring Niger Delta Republic on June of January and for January. Where is it? We have passed there. We are going to July. There are mad people. Mad people. It no go happen. It no go. It did happen. You don't touch our Niger Delta. It did. Come enter backyard. Is it a lot that is puffing you? It will never happen. It will ever happen. The whole nation will soon be overrun by Sharia law. The whole nation will soon be overrun by Fulani herdsmen. The whole nation will soon be overrun by British government. Am I calling nation? The whole country, the whole zoo will soon be overrun. It will never happen until 180 million people become refugees overnight all over the world. It will never happen. Stop deceiving yourself. That is the end of this journey. It will unleash mayhem in the zoo called Nigeria. It will affect the Oduduwa. It will affect the Arewa. It will affect the Biafrans. And then when we are done with ourselves, we will move against Africa. Africa will receive a number of refugees that he has not started. Maybe South Africa are doing genophobia or phobia zenu. Get ready. Because what is coming, you people are not ready. And when we are done with Libya and South Africa and all the Alamajiri countries that are trying to stop Biafran emergence, we will get to Europe. We will get there. We will get there. We will drink that. What do they call that river that kills our people? Do they call it Atlantic Ocean or Mediterranean Sea? We will drink that river dry. We are Islam already. You want them to Islamize us? We are Islam already. Britain, Islam rape your daughters. Islam has turned your land to uninhabited. We will come as Islam. That thing you are looking for. You can chase them everywhere. German came to discuss with Nigeria how to repatriate Nigeria. German, you are doing the right thing. But you have been repatriating Nigerian to Ghana, giving them 50 euro. But I'm not blaming you, because everybody that said they are Nigerian, there are three countries in Nigeria. Yorubas are 419, deport them. Awusa are terrorists, deport them. If they are genuine Biafran with IPOB, accept them. Because any Biafran in German that is not an IPOB, question their position. They are mixed blood. If they are not associating directly or indirectly, deport them. Don't negotiate with Nigeria. Bring all the whole refugee in the world. Heap them in Nigeria. And misery has just begun. Look at what Yoruba and Benin people are doing in Germany. Oh no, on their body, Sunday, Benin, ndi dure, ejo, ejo one we buale. Okay, kekeji unu kekeji tehiona, weweji shona pato makasa, unu ejo one we buale. Eli akata. I cut out my foot. But we must continue. Like I said, our topic is simple. History is about to repeat itself. Most of you, many of the people of Biafra, don't want to stand up against this evil, even when they can see it coming clearly. Some don't want to lose their position. You see evil. Evil is coming before you. You don't want to stand up against this evil. You are sitting down. You are speaking BB grammar. Yeah, man, we got to move on, man. I'm going to learn French and German and Italian and Britain, Queen's English, and then I'm going to give it to you. But I'm happy I can speak American now. And I'm speaking it, man, very clear, man. Those in America understand that I'm speaking it clear and loud, man. They are mad people. Before your very eye, you are seeing this evil. You keep it quiet. History is about to repeat itself. But I don't blame you. But let me tell you what happens. You don't want to lose your position in Nigeria. So you are not an IPOB and you are not supportive of what you are doing. I understand. There are people who existed like you before now, before the war. Ojukwu say, come back. Zeke don't want. Now there are Zeke we don't want. He don't want to lose Zeke of Africa. Do anybody even know? In fact, sit your children down. Those of your children born in the 90s. Ask them, do you know who is Nnamdi Azikiwe? They can't even pronounce the name, not to talk of knowing who he is. You don't want to lose your position. Nnamdi Azikiwe fought against Ojukwu in Biafra land. He worked against Biafran people. Staying in Biafra land, working with Nigerian to undo Ojukwu. And some people think they will have that privilege this time. Paramono. Lani hunu reme no to, unu rejo one we buale. Lani hen unu reme to, makenu no amani hen remeni. We don't threaten people. We make you a promise. Most of you are following that path. If I join IPOB now, they will take my position. But if they will take it, it's just that it's not yet time. Don't let anybody deceive you. That is why our governors are selling us out. Senators and rep and all of them are selling us out. Because they want second tenure. You will not do what you're supposed to do. Because some of you are truly afraid of your money in bank account. I have considered, I say, if Biafra come today now, look at the millions that people have in Nigerian bank. They will seize all of them. And Chukwu Kikabiama said to me, but they've done it before. They will still do it again. My mother is a victim of that. So when you are there, you are saying, oh, do you know how many billion I have in Nigerian bank? They will take it from you. Whether today or tomorrow, they will take it from you. Except Biafra is restored. Did they not do it to your parents? My mother never had a bank account. And I asked her one day, I said, mommy, why don't you take this money to the bank? He said, during the war. Because they are afraid to call Biafra during the war. They took all her money, Wolowo and Yoruba, with Nigerian government and British government. Took all my mother money. Can they pay me back? That is when I see DSA, they are trying to bribe you. Leave your head, Biafra, follow us, we give you money. Can you refund? Give me back my mother money you took. Let's see if you have anything to bribe me. Ndiara, some of you are saying, if I give now, they will freeze my account. But they will freeze it. It's just that, not now. But it shall. They shall. And others say, I can't join them because I don't want to lose my properties across Nigeria. Go and look at all Biafrans who are fighting against IPOB. They either have house in Yoruba land or they have house in Hausa land. And they say, no, I can't lose it. No, these people want me to lose my property. I'm not going to join them. You're going to join us whether you like it or not. If K is not taking, we lose all of them. If they can seize your land in River State, Iguacha, Biafra land, is it Yoruba land you are running for? You don't know what is coming for you. Sometimes you give it up. Sometimes it will be taken from you. Jesus said, for I lay down my life, not because any man can take it from me. And then if I lay it down, I can pick it up again. Lay down your property. Not because anybody is taking it from you. That is the only way you can take it up again. So because of one bungalow in Lagos, you think that bungalow is... Now, I want you to think about what 10 million people would have achieved if they were not murdered by Nigerian and British government. Imagine, let me digress, let me be a little bit unhuman. You take 10 million kidney, 10 million liver, 10 million, what are these things they are killing our people to harness? Kidney, liver, and what? Lungs and heart. And now sell it to America, sell it to all these people buying kidney and liver. Imagine how many millions we will have. All year will be valueless. And then your father have one bank and he say, IPOB, don't give us what, don't give us what. You are Ijo Ibukwe. You build one duplex somewhere in Ajegule. They will take it from you. History is about to repeat itself. It will be taken from you. Others has already compromised the blood of their ancestors. And so when you are talking, Yoruba, there are a lot of people who are not happy with me when I talk about the atrocity of Yoruba against Biafra people. Why? Because their mother is a Yoruba, their wife is a Yoruba, they have a Yoruba or Hausa family. They are not happy. They can be opening their teeth. I know all of them. I know all of you. So when you come here attacking me or embossing me or talking to me, I know you. You marry Yoruba, not my fault. You marry Hausa, not my fault. Do not let the love of your mother to destroy. Watch your father, the foundation of your father. We've seen it happen before. Obumudia is a very good example of that. Don't let the love of your mother destroy the foundation of your father. We will not make mistake about that. So because you marry Yoruba now, or you marry Hausa, my own brother marry Hausa, I have told him, the day we will enter my father's house, I don't buy stick for him to lead Meru Melu. I will personally buy cow for him and send his children back to Hausa to Fiakwa. He's listening to me. Not to talk of you. Not to talk of you. You think you think we dare here they pity ourselves? Yes, so because you marry Yoruba, your mama na Yoruba, your papa na Hausa, you marry Hausa, you befriend Hausa, your family blood don't miss. You just don't know you are a threat. The moment you allow the love of your motherland, Hausa Yoruba, to destroy the foundation of your ancestors, your father, you are a threat to the Biafran community. You better give Igbo name to all those Hausa women and Yoruba you are bringing to Biafra land. So because of it now, you are friending Yoruba girl. We should not talk about Biafra. Pack your motto. If you don't hate your situation, that situation will destroy you. We don't pamper sickness. Our leader say, when we see What do they call the sickness?
Cancer. We don't pamper it. You cut it off.
You cut it off.
Most of you are confused. You just don't know the way forward. And this is how you know them. When you meet them, you say, how do you see this Biafra? He said, this is your Biafra issue. I beg, leave me. You prove to them with point. He said, this Biafra issue, I don't know. Anyone, if it's Nigeria, I'm there. If it's Biafra, I'm there. They are confused fellas.
If care is not taken, they will kill you. For what they don't even know. Because they are confused. They are confused. Majority of the people are afraid of what will happen. Of what has happened before now.
Oh, I know. You didn't see the war. That is why you are saying what you are saying. If you know what happened during the war, you will not be talking about Biafra.
Did Biafra fight war? They brought war on us.
Is APOB fighting war? Of course not. They are the one killing us. And you are telling us, oh, if he has seen the war, if he...
Ha! All these things you are afraid of, they will come to you.
It's coming to you. History is about to repeat itself.
My mother had money in the bank, it was taken. They will seize all the money in your bank. Every Biafran that have money, they will seize it. Every Biafran occupying the position, you will be dislodged. You don't know what is coming. In all this, you are right. We know it. And they know it. That is why they did all these things to us in the first place.
All this is I've mentioned. We know the truth and you know it. Awosa know it. Yoruba know it. That is why they did it to you in the first place. So that we, your children, will not be able to speak up. We know.
If you look closely at the situation at hand, you will see that all these things they did to our fathers, all these things you are afraid of, has already begun to happen to us as we speak. It has already begun to happen. We don't want your position to be taken. They have made you irrelevant in the political statue of Nigeria. Senate President, Vice President, President of Nigeria.
Where are you, Oyi Biafra, of one Nigerianist?
It has started already. Yes, you are afraid. Your money in bank will be taken. Of course, it shall. One Alamajiri signature. Initia. They don't have signature. It's initia. You know, initia is a... When you don't have signature, you use fingerprint. Then you back it up with initia. You now put... Maybe your name is Peter Okoro. You now put P-O. One Alamajiri Fulani Barawu Dambanza. We use his initia and freeze your bank account. Why can't politicians talk? Because DSS and ICPC and EFCC, they are waiting for you to freeze your account. Most of you don't know. My accounts have been frozen. It has been flagged up by one Nigerian terrorist I don't know. Not because I've committed any crime. Because I'm an IPOB. You think your own is going to be free? My banks are freezed up. So if you're afraid of it, it is happening already. Some of you are afraid. You don't want to lose your property. It has started already. There is a hotel in Abuja where they wear pijad, all these strippers to do show. I was burnt it down. But these people smoke Igbo, smoke tramadol, but they condemn your beer. Has it not started already?
And then you say, you see, I marry Yoruba. Does it change anything? Even our self blooded, they are killing everyone. Is it you that will be saved?
You are confused. You don't know. When they shoot their bullet, the bullet, you say, no, this man don't know anything about Biafra. Don't kill her. Don't kill him. Get ready because you have no idea what is coming. Don't make any mistake about it. Do not forget our topic. It's simple. The history. History is about to repeat itself.
Ignoring this warning is like dying with a slow poison. which is even worse than before, because they will never have enough time to finish all that is left of us. Unlike now. Oh, ignore them. Ignore them. Don't mind them. Let me tell you what you don't know. Our fathers have enough time to negotiate. If you ignore what we are telling you today as a Biafra, you are just like somebody who has said to eat slow poison instead of dying with sharp, sharp poison. You know, when you drink sniper, you are gone. When they give you slow poison, you will die slowly. You will die painfully, but you will die in the end. You fail to stand up and fight for Biafra restoration. You will die with slow poison, painfully, slowly, certainly you will die. Make no mistake about it. Our fathers didn't die with poison. They had time to renegotiate, to redecide what they do. That is why somebody like Philippe Effiong had the privilege of going to hand over the government and leadership of Biafra land to Hausa and Yoruba. They did their job well. But if you don't want to do the needful, let me tell you what will happen. They are the ones who are having advantage of time over us. They are killing us systematically, poisoning us slowly. Painfully, we are dying. Very soon, you are this fragilizing Igbo. You are this connection Igbo. You are this politicalizing Igbo. Who? You are how do they say it? Is it Bill of Rights? You are Bill of Rights of us. You are resource controlizing us. We are Niger detonizing us. We will not agree. Who? You're dying. You're taking slow poison and you are dying gradually, painfully. Certainly you will die. If you claim that fighting against the government of injustice, the government of corruption, the government of disenfranchisement, the government of emasculation, this evil enclave called Nigeria, if you claim that you don't want to be part of it, that is why you don't want. Well, go ahead. Do your one Nigeria. But there are truths you should know. Coming together is their worst nightmare. They spent almost 200 years dividing us. And it's unbelievable that almost 200 years later, we're waking up, we're coming together. This is their worst nightmare. Some people will come and say, I'm fighting for Urobo Nation. Another one we take Igbo and say, I'm fighting for Isekiri Nation. The other one we take Tramadol, I'm fighting for Izion Nation. The other one we take Ogogoro, I'm fighting for Abo Nation. Then another one we take Apatashi, I'm fighting for Akwa Ibom Nation. Woo. That is what they want. They will pick you out one after the other. They will crush you. They will destroy you. Your voice will not be heard. You will be gone forever. Nations have been wiped off. Breed of Homo sapiens has been decimated and wiped out across the face of the planet. Your own is not new. But they fear the day will come together. They fear the day where we no longer know ourselves as Akwa Ibom, as Igbo, as Abo, as Urobo, as Isekiri, as Ijaw, as Ogoni, as Andone, as Iduma, as Igala. They fear that day, and we are coming together already. And you see, they cannot hold it any longer. They can't hold it any longer. So we must bury our ego. Bury that your ego. Do you know who I am? Do you know what I do? Do you know my bank account? Bury that ego. Look for IPOB family closer to you and join. I'm afraid. You're afraid. Your fear will not save you. Wherever you are in Africa, start IPOB family member. Contact Radio Biafra Extra. Contact George Onyibe, or if you know the regional reps, West African or North African, South African, East African, West African, any coordinator in Africa, contact them. You are in Europe, you are in America, you are in Asia, you are in Malaysia, you are in Indonesia, you are anywhere on the face of the planet Earth. And that place you are, there is no IPOB family. Do not misquote me. When I say stand one family, I'm not telling you to become a general overseer. I'm not telling you to start your own campaign. I'm asking you to do the needful. There is a massive eclosion of Biafran nation across the globe. The cycle must be completed. But when we say we must come together, you think I'm telling you to come together so that a coalition of Ondiara and Andyoshi, you think you are here to do coalition of Ondiara and Andyoshi? Look for IPOB family closer to you. Join. If you see Iruanya, tell him to look for any family in, what do they call that? Is it Minnesota? Let him join one. If you see Anemela, tell him to look for IPOB family in Brazil and join one. Wherever you are, you see Asare Dokubo, tell him to leave Bayelsa State. He should go back to River State and join one in Calabari land. Let them swallow their ego. Let them swallow their pride. Because history is about to repeat itself. Make no mistake about it. The coming of our people together will end this evil. Not coming together of 419. Over time, they were on social media. Oh, let's unite. Let's coalize. Let's coalition. Coalization or coalition is 419. Go and look for IPOB family and join you. Igodomi Godo, Agadami Gada, Ogudumu Gudu. All those conductors in Germany and America coming on social media to give their stinking mouth to IPOB. Igodomi Godo, Igadami Gada. But my message tonight is simple. History is about to repeat itself. Where will you be when it starts? Will you be on the path of righteousness? Will you be on the path of evil? I'll be back in a minute.
This song is dedicated to the victims of this genocide. Those who lost their lives from 1967 to this very moment.
I had to do this song with you. My brother, man, I don't believe you. Shake a man, could beat you. My brother, man, listen up. Tell that Biafra soldier that he's gonna be the right. I need to tell that Biafra soldier that he's gonna be the right. Follow me, tell that Biafra soldier that he's gonna be the right. To us, playing coward, I see the corona. But we will win them all. I say we will win them all. Man, the kind who is the leader. He says he's gonna be alright. He's gonna be alright. Tell that Biafra soldier that he's gonna be alright. I need to tell that Biafra soldier. That is gonna be alright. Follow me, tell that Biafra soldier. That is gonna be alright. Follow me, tell that Biafra soldier. That is gonna be alright. Tell that Biafra soldier.
Man, from my nation, Biafra land. Hey, oh na na na, what a wicked world. I want a junior, another day, Biafra. Shot by
a government. Because of our freedom, we are fighting for a better life. One thing I know, for whatever, like whatever, we will one day have a better day. Someday, sometime soon.
Tell that Biafra soldiers that is gonna be the life. I need to tell that Biafra soldier that is gonna be the life. Follow me, tell that Biafra soldier that is gonna be alright. Follow me, tell that Biafra soldier.
Yes, at this moment, our lines are open. Our WhatsApp line is 070-815-45642. Our WhatsApp line, I repeat once again, is 070-815-45642. Our direct line is 081-221-52971. Our direct line is 081-221-52971. And a special number dedicated to our mothers, our sisters, our daughters, and our wives is 081-288-58614. Special number dedicated to the female is 081-228-288. I beg your pardon, 58614. And at this moment, our lines are open. Don't let them poison us gradually. History has started repeating itself again. Where will you be? Where will you be? Are you going to be a spectator? Are you going to be an invigilator? Are you going to be a saboteur? Are you going to be the enemy? Are you going to be British government? Are you going to be a Duduwa nation? Are you going to be Arawa nation? Or are you going to stand by the side of the Biafra nation? For this is all we ask. To be the author of our destiny. Nothing more, nothing less. But we must continue. Caller on the line, your name and where are you calling from?
Hello, sir. I want to call Kikabiama.
Adadino Rama, go ahead, please. The world is listening.
God bless you. I want to speak. What I wanted to speak this night. My name is Happiness Eninaya. The name of my coordinator is Abaka. I'm speaking from Idocha, which they call Port Harcourt. What I wanted to say this night is as regards to our men. I want to say that when men were men, they are being regarded with their words. And they are being taken serious with their words. I've heard the chairman of World Igbo Congress speaking. I am asking Chukwu Okikadama to let him remain and abide by the words that comes out from his mouth. We don't underneath people of Rabo Rousers in this restoration. My regards and my respect goes to him. I'm not saying he's that type of person. But all what I'm saying is that may God send us names of their words that will keep to their words. When they speak, they will embark on what they have spoken for the restoration of Biafra. We are not begging for Biafra. We are not asking Hausa and Fulani to give us Biafra. But just as Obasanjo said, that our destiny is in our hands. Let us come out in mass, in one accord, and remain and take Biafra by the strength of Chukwu Biama. This is what I wanted to contribute to this man. May God bless you.
Thank you, Ada.
May God keep you and protect you in the mighty
you
see, I pray.
You see,
thank you very much. You see, and God bless you.
You see, our people must understand. We are not begging you. We are appealing to your conscience that you wake up to your responsibility. Because that thing which you fear about Nigeria and British government will come upon you. Everything you fear will come upon you. But if we come together, with one voice we speak together, we will form an impenetrable unit. That nothing can ever separate. But this impenetrable unit cannot be formed by 419 and the seed of Judas. No, men and women who have buried their ego, men and women who have put the interest of their nation ahead of their personal ego and quest. Call on the line, your name and where are you calling from?
Hello?
Good evening, your name and where are you calling from?
I'm calling from Aba.
Go ahead, please.
Hello?
Give us order. Give us order. Ordinary radio station. You cannot ignore your radio and focus on your phone. Give us order. Give us. Awusa have been listening to radio. Awusa Lamaziri, Ezeguru have been listening to radio. Wake up, my people. Can you hear me? Caller on the line. Of course, you epileptic network. We must continue. Caller on the line, are you there? Caller on the line, are you there? Caller on the line, Hello? Are you there? If you are there, please go ahead. Your name and where are you calling from?
I'm today, Roman. I'm calling from Ada.
Go ahead, Ada.
Is this Radio Biafra?
Of course, this is Radio Biafra. Where do you want to call?
I want to call the bank in Abad, the one that's listening to this night.
Bank. We have not opened Biafra Bank. Thank you very much.
Okay, sir.
Yes, sir. Caller on the line, your name and where are you calling from?
Hello, this is Emmanuel Chukwuemeka.
Go ahead, please. The world is listening.
I'm calling from Amobia, but I'm from Agulele. Yeah, thank you, my brother. Because I'm really happy whenever I'm listening to your comments all the time. You see that your words always make me to listen to this Biafran struggle. In fact, I'm happy for you. I'm happy for all the leaders of IPOB. I'm happy also for all the members of IPOB worldwide. I think that my God Almighty be with you all. In Jesus' name. Hello? Okay, thank you. So I would like to talk to you privately. I don't know whether you can, you know, allow me for that. Okay, thank you. I will do that later. So,
we must good continue. Night. Good night from here. Caller on WhatsApp. Caller on WhatsApp, your name and where are you calling from?
Hello.
Good evening from here. Your name and where are you calling from?
I'm Onyibe. Bless you. I am, my name is Pastor Ejofo Augustine. I am calling from Ozoboro. Though I am from Oli. And Linehalo government, they have a number of states, and that is Biafra land. So I am just want to use the opportunity to appreciate your effort and what you have been doing. In fact, my soul has been gladdened each time I listen to you. And each time I hear your voice and how you explain the ordeal. In fact, our suffering and our pains in this enclave called Nigeria. So I want to say, God continue to bless you and strengthen you and give you the ability to continue in the name of Yahushua.
Thank you very much. We must continue. Call on WhatsApp. Can you hear me? Your name and where are you calling from?
Hello. Good evening.
Good evening, ma'am. From here, go ahead, please.
Okay. Watching it. There were. I thank you so much. You're always making us proud for all your teaching, for all your wonderful work to we Biafrans. May Chukwu Okabiama, Almighty Chukwu Okabiama, continue blessing you, continue empowering you, because I know, especially on your own side, you are the mouth of the lion, but you know, nothing will happen for you. That's my prayer 24 hours of my life. At the same time, I'm praying to our Koka Biama for the life of our leader. I know. Our deputy, Captain, May Almighty Chukwuka bless every one of you. My name is Madam Tesi Chiojukwu from Amich, here south in Biafran land. What I'm adding this night, Maze Onyibe, you will live long to see Biafra. But I'm begging all hardcore, all Biafra worldwide, please. As we are hearing, look at what all these our presenters, 24 hours, morning, night, as we are listening, let the thing continue entering our brain. Let the thing continue entering our life. Stop having doubting mind or fear. Our freedom is out our hand. I strongly believe that in our life, we are to get our Biafra. No matter, nothing will stop us not to get Biafra. But we have to rise up, especially our men. Rise up. If you know that your brother don't know what is IPOP family, from today, go and join. And made up your own family, inaugurate your own family to be strong so that our enemy, all of them, will perish. Both the saboteurs, because Biafra struggle is a divine project. I don't have any fear, I don't have any doubt in mind. So, what I'm pleading this night, let everybody wake up, let everybody rise up, let all join hands together. We are at the last bus stop now. We are going to get our great nation of Biafra. At the same time, I'm using this opportunity. Yes. At the same time, I'm using this opportunity to thank all our brothers and sisters that they released for Enugu today. I'm so proud. You people are welcome. Okay? So may all my teach co-cabia bless all of us. Everybody that is directing this struggle. That we are going to get what we want. In our extra name, I pray.
Thank you very much for giving me time.
Okay, my dear. Good night.
Continue. Good night from here. Yes, sir. Caller on the line. Your name and where are you calling from, please? Mazia Parawara, are you there?
Yes.
Good evening, please. Good evening.
Good evening, sir. Good evening, my fellow comrade. Good evening. The lovers of freedom. Good evening, good afternoon, good morning, wherever you are. My name is Aparawa Emmanuel Ogamma. I happen to be the coordinator of Akwaba Sibom. The reason of me coming to aid this hour is to declare and make it known to the world that the zoo police in Akwa Ibom have started a serious war with us. Right this afternoon, they start from there. I sent my comrades to take food to those that they were apprehended yesterday, and they reject giving them the food. I don't know what that stands for, and I don't know what is in their mind. I want them to know quite well. I want them to know that there is no amount of intimidation, there is no amount of play the rough game that they are going to play that will stop us from being fighting for the freedom of our children, of our dear nation. It was yesterday when we were on the program, this guy walked into the field twice. And we were looking at them. They come and come again. We still observe them. They go and approach our elders, start begging for money. Then I advise them, if that is what they want, they should do it to them. Because everybody knows that the zoo police are good in collecting money. I wonder how a man who says that he is not interested or is serving a nation that is collecting his salary somewhere. He's still going around begging. When you see people gathering, they will go and beg. Even when we give them the money that they demand, they later still come back to make sure that they cause havoc in the program. Well, we did that because we were not going out there to make any trouble with them. They took our men yesterday, our brothers and sisters who came on the way from Port Harcourt to come and be the part of the program, to come and see what is happening. And then to make sure that they unite the Akwa Ibomite all over, because the title of the program, Time to Go Back Home. We call our people to come and identify with what we are doing here and show love and showcase and know that the same person, the same job that you are doing in Anambra, if you are Akwa Ibom person staying in Anambra, is the same thing that we are doing in Akwa Ibom. The same thing that is happening in Wacha, wherever you find yourself, is the same thing that is happening here. And the people cooperated and they cooperate and they make up their mind to come in and see what is going on in Akwa Ibom and see where we can be able to stand in a gap to be our assistant in case of any eventuality, so that our people will not come back home and start to get quarrel with themselves. We put down that program and they obey and come out. Then the zoo police decided to come and disrupt us, and they make that happen. We did not intervene. We did not make any trouble. But suddenly, as soon as they left that place, they went and marked a roadblock on the road. That is where they got they arrested our brothers and sisters, and they took them yesterday night under that rain to the police station. And they keep them there in the place that without no protection, nothing for somebody to lie on, under that cold weather. After that, they now decided to treat them again to that, to Ikorok Banabia, where we have the police headquarters in that night. But along the line, because I was following the journey, they did not know who was behind them, because I've made up my mind, wherever this journey will take us to, we will be there. Along the line, they decided to turn back again. I don't know what was in their mind. I don't know what they suspect. I turned back and I followed them. They took them back and they took them at that AA division. It was this morning that they finally took them to Ikotok Banabia, where they are till this hour. I sent the women in charge to take food to them, and they reject giving collecting food for them. I don't know what is in their mind. I want the world to hear this, because there is no amount of intimidation that will stop us from doing what we are doing. I'm calling out Akwa Ibom people, the brothers and sisters, wherever you are in the world, hearing the sound of my voice, this is what is going on in Akwa Ibom province. Our brothers and our fathers fight the civil war, and they give us the right to know who we are. And with that, now we have a leader who knows the road and is pursuing the vision without any intimidation, without any fear. Therefore, we, the followers of him, from Akwa Ibom, we have made up our mind. No surrender, no retreat. We will not go back. We will not render our effort. We have come out because those who follow the first set of people, what they call them, the Masob, the man fell them on the road. Then they patiently wait to see whether this one will be the same. But we thank God that this one has made a difference. The differences has been clear, as those are we will not have seven up. Therefore, now this is the journey. The battle has started in Akwa Ibom. We will not give up until Biafra is restored, because we are yet to do the needful. What are we here for? Biafra must be restored for our children. It is our right to be free, and we must be free. Therefore, I use this opportunity to call on Akwa Ibom people, wherever you are, we needed your support. Remember that Nehemiah of Jerusalem, come back home and make sure that your state is also built, to be firm, to be strong, and to do the work, because we must work together. The word says, together we stand, and divided we fall. And I know that we will not fall, because the grace of God is upon us. We must do it perfectly. We must also make sure that the voice of Akwa Ibom is heard all over the world, that we are the people of Biafra, and nothing stops us from being who we are. No matter the trick, no matter the plan of the outer Fulani Esmen, no matter whatever they put him on ground to say that they will dominate us one day, I am very, very much sure that the God that created the heaven and earth, the Most High God, will not allow us to be destroyed in their hand. Rather, he will give us our inheritance. Because the Bible says that the good father leaving an inheritance to his children. They do fight and give us this opportunity to remain and do what we are doing. They were not fool. But that the fullness of time, we, the children and the remnant, we have arrived. Therefore, must be restored. Nothing will stop us. Therefore, as I was saying before, please hear me well. Send the message to your family. There must be a family. There must be a unit in your village. Whether you like it or not, remember, wherever you are, one day you will come down. There must be a unit in their village. We are not afraid of their bullets. We are not afraid of their cell. We are not afraid of their knife. We are not afraid of whatever they will do. Whatever the Fulanis are looking for, we are well capable of waiting there. And that is why we at our elders says, let them start it. We know how to handle them. So that is what I'm saying this evening. Use it as a point of contact. Make sure that you reach out to your people. With that, no time, because we don't have the time. We know that Biafra is at the corner. As the Biafra is coming, please do everything possible to make sure that your family, your brothers, your sisters are in line with what they are doing. Because other people are doing it effectively, you must do it the same way they are doing it. With that, no time, no, because we don't have any further time to waste. All hail Biafra.
Thank you very much, all hail Biafra. Hopefully, you people must follow closely to them, bomber to bomber. We want the true identity of all the people in Nigerian custody. We want the name of all those people. Contact of the next of kin, because these people will poison them. They are evil, but we must continue. Thank you very much for the update. Yes, sir. Caller on WhatsApp, are you there?
Good evening from here, from Sweden.
Good evening, Maz.
My name is Tiriman Maze Shukwemeka Shuku Kandia Jamado. I'm from Isnifite, it's an Inewu South local government. Nkedina Biafra land. I will continue thanking God for gift of Radio Biafra and our leader Maz and all of you guys that are working seriously for we to achieve our goal, which is called Biafra. The problem of our people, and no one wants to lose any of his property, but as long as they will lose it, it doesn't concern him or her. Everybody must stand up, or you lose your life and lose your property. That is the only way out. Record it and put it in tape and be sharing it to everybody to listen. And what Ahmed Dubello say is what late Buhari or Dubri is about to complete this time around, so that everybody should understand what is going on. Okay, I did a British government and Mama and Cha. When you feel like a prince, if oil and gas, because of oil and gas. It makes me to understand that it's this British government that bring war to us in 1967, because they mislead Yakubu Gowon, and which they know that the agreement was signed and written. The agreement and Yakubu Gowon is signature to the agreement. The world knows all the sense. They went ahead and commit genocide to us, to the Biafrans. Simple, because of Ojukwu have no intention to declare Biafra, just to move Nigeria forward. The same thing that is happening because of oil and gas, British government confuse Gowon for him to change his mind and everything. All Gowon and all those northern outside oligarchy, because of oil and gas, pretending that they want to keep Nigeria warm. What's up, tough? This is very, very, very big atrocity. Any other abụọ na mahi fe juo kedi ihe ana akọ ife kedi etu okwu asu we bido okwu abụọ na nwere mbido nwere njetabe onye chọrọ ụfọdụ ndị mmadụ achọghị m onye ọbụla dị busy. All of us are busy fighting, looking for money, looking for wealth. Do we lose it? You will lose all your wealth. I promise you that. You will lose it, and you will lose your life. The time is at hand. Everybody should get prepared, whether you like it or not. Freedom is taken. It's not given. Anya no Russia na abroad na akoyeri na na eriri smart potato na ngome ko akho mmiri shem ifere mebu anyi maze. I have no much to say than thank to you. Say continue your good work. God will see us through.
Thank you.
God will deliver us from the hand of British. Even it's not even outside Europe are our problem. The problem we have is British government, the mighty powers. But God, Almighty God, God in heaven, must destroy them whether they like it or not. God will destroy them. As long as this heaven and earth is existing, God is ready to do wonder. And the Biafra will be the last miracle as long as our leader has it. Because I so much believe in his words. His prophecy is true. But we must stand up and take the bull by the horn, whether we like it or not. No going back. Biafra or dead. Goodbye from here.
Thank you. We must continue. Caller on the line, your name and where are you calling from? This is female line. This is female line. Caller on the line, your name and where are you calling from? Good evening from here. Go ahead, please.
Thank you for picking my call. My name is Mazi Okando Zone. Mazi Okando Zone is from the music in the province of Biafra. But I'm coming from Aba province. Mazi, I thank you for your work. The effort you are putting in this struggle. I thank you for what you are doing for us. Which could you ever bless you in the name of your Yeshua. I also thank our leader Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, our leader of Biafra land. And Mazi Uchen Uka from the fork, our deputy leader. I say, may any of you give them strength for their efforts they are putting in this struggle. For their tenacity, I say, which will them address them in the name of your Yeshua. Mazi, I want to use this opportunity to identify with our brothers, Papa Ibim. We want to identify today with their struggle, their suffering, their suffering with me now. Anything we need them and protect them. No one has of enemy will do anything to them. I want to ask our brothers, those living in diaspora, to let their help in this struggle. Because this struggle needs a financial support. We need transmitter in Oliver and Oliver, the new sacraments of their land. We want everybody to know what is happening. But some of our brothers in the village, they are not listening to the Biafra. When we talk to them about Biafra, they say they are not listening to radio. So we need our brothers, these living Biafra, to help us. Please, this struggle needs a financial commitment. And also, our brothers here, who don't want to join this struggle, don't know what is the problem. Mazi, you know, some people, they like what Mazi Nnamdi Kanu is doing. They want to listen to the Biafra, and they like IPOB. They don't want to join the struggle. I don't know what is their problem.
But if they are Yoruba or Hausa blood, do you expect them to join us?
Maybe I know. Some of them, they want to listen to the Biafra.
So leave them. Through Biafra. Who, did anybody force you? Did anybody beg you to join IPOB?
Nobody
and so why are you forcing Yoruba and Hausa to join IPOB?
Yeah, correct. And because they join the struggle, they don't want to do it. They are
Thank you. God be with you. Caller on the line on WhatsApp, your name and where are you calling from? Caller on WhatsApp, are you there?
Good morning, Master George. My name is Eichineke. Eichineke, I'm calling from Malaysia. Good morning, Biafrans. Good afternoon, Biafrans. Good evening, Biafrans. Good night, Biafrans and lovers of freedom, depending on your time zone. Master George, I've listened to your broadcast this early hour of the morning here. From what our first caller said regarding to the World Igbo Congress leader, what he said. Director went to US and make broadcast there. He told them pump and play what he wanted, and they never listened to him. Today, sometimes when I just sit down and watch them, snapping video with our snapping pictures with our tablet or taking picture, I keep asking myself, is it not the same man that when he traveled to before and told them what is happening in Nigeria, and they neglected him? They all sat down eating bucket of ice cream. Had woken up when our director went there since 2015. I don't think things would have been this way up to now. Then I listened to that our father who called from Akwa Ibom, who he said that the wife took food to our people and they rejected the food. He said something. He said when Wazirike came the first time, he misled the people. And when our director came the second time, their people withdrew somehow. They were watching. And finally, they discovered that our director is the right person. That is true. Betrayal is one of the key points that has kept our people in the situation that we found ourselves today. That is why when you watch from all our politicians from A to Z, no one is to be trusted. Look at Ike Ekweremadu. Nothing to show for it. He knew that he was a Biafra, but he never took that opportunity. They all kept mute. Look at this homosexual Ojisokandi. He's no longer ranting. He's not talking about IPOB any longer. And after his Fulani masters have disappointed him from becoming the Senate president, he is nowhere today. You will never hear from them. You will never see them again until when it is 4 years' time again after the election now. You will see them. They will all spring out from their holes, coming out again to these people. Today, they are no more saying anything. Every one of them has went into hiding. Then, when you look at what is happening in the zone now, they just newly appointed 27 judges in the country now in the federation. My question now is, these judges that they just appointed, what is their function? What is their work in that zoo called Nigeria? Because we have a lot of judges, yet crime is taking place on a daily basis. They don't even convict those people committing those crimes. Hausa Fulani are busy killing people, raping, destroying lives and properties, yet the police cannot arrest. Any one of them. So what is the purpose of all these judges that they are appointing here and there? That is a big question one need to ask. And again, I watch one Yoruba pastor woman on Facebook. She was crying that somebody wrote an article, probably a Yoruba family who came from the US to the zoo, that she and the family were kidnapped by Hausa Fulani. They were raped. They raped the daughter. They did this. She was just crying. Any of his church members, you people are all deceivers. Are you going to tell me that since Fulani herdsmen have been killing people, raping other people, destroying life, cutting pregnant women open, innocent children of 1 to 2 to 3 years are being killed, you never see all those things? You never preach about it in your church. You never social media to condemn it. You never wept for all those people because now they kidnap a Yoruba person, and now you are coming. And now you are coming to the public to start telling the world that Mr. President needs to rise up, that security apparatus need to do this. Well, my sister, if you are hearing me, your brother who is the vice president, who's supposed to be a Christian, who's supposed to protect the Christian bodies, he is not saying anything. So all of you are the same people. The only everybody need to wake up from their sleep so that we'll join hands together and fight this fight once and for all, so that every one of us will be free.
We must continue. Our people must remain focused. We are not going anywhere. Don't let anybody deceive you. As a Biafran, don't let anybody distract you. Our target and our destination is Biafra land. A special announcement coming up to us at this moment. Special announcement coming up this moment. Mazi Nandekano will be coming to Houston for return hall meeting. Our Supreme Leader Mazi Nandekano Kano will also be visiting Houston, America, for a town hall meeting. IPUB family in Houston at this moment is inviting you. The date is going to be June 22, 2019, Houston Marathon Watch House, 2900 Brad Park, Dr. Houston, Texas, 7702. Come with your question concerning Biafra. And for further inquiries, you have to contact the following people. Wada Monachi Sunaga Opala, Houston Coordinator, on 713-417-9366. Once again, for further inquiry on the visit of our Supreme Leader Mazi Nandekano to Houston, where he's going to address IPUB family in Houston on the town hall meeting, everybody is welcome with their questions, contribution and suggestion. And so for further inquiry to be part of this very great day, you need to contact number one, Wanda Monachi Sunaga Opala, Houston Coordinator. Our number is 713-417-9366. Or you can also contact Mazi Oliver Anosike on the following phone number, 832-341-2374. He's the unit secretary. Mazi Oliver Anosike, you can contact him on 832-341-2374. He is the unit coordinator. Also, you can contact Mwada Augusta Anosiki, who is the financial secretary, on 713-402-8158. I repeat again, 713-402-8158. Or better still, you can also contact Nwada Helen Anojulu on 0. Why am I keeping saying 0? On 832-266-3112. Nwada Helen Anojulu is the unit treasurer. You can also contact her for further inquiry to be part of that great day on the 22nd of this month of June, when our leader will be visiting IPOB family in Houston to address them in a town hall meeting. Wanda Helen Anojulu, number is 832-266-3112. Mazi Romeo Wogo, you can also contact him on 832-709-732. Mazi Vito Ohile, or Ohile. You can also contact him on 664-421-8985. Once again, our Supreme Leader Mazen Nandi Okukano will be visiting IPUB family member in Houston on the 22nd of this month of June 2019. The time will be from 2 to 7 p.m. From 2 to 7 p.m. Houston Marot, West Jersey, 2900. Bariak Park, be there. Make sure you don't miss out. Biafra Freedom, Biafra Freedom, Biafra Freedom. Biafra community in New York, New Jersey, under the leadership of Mazen Nandi Okukano, hereby invite all Biafras, friends of Biafras and lovers of freedom, in the New York, New Jersey, welcome. You are welcome to join the IPOB family in New York and in New Jersey, as we welcome our Supreme Leader Mazen Nandi Okukano on his historical visit to the New York New Jersey family. The date of his visit is on the 30th of June 2019. From Houston, of course, he will be going to New Jersey, New York. And so IPOB family in New York and New Jersey, on the 30th of May, on the 30th of June 2019, the time is 12 noon to 8 p.m. The venue of the visit of our Supreme Leader Mazen Nandi Okukano to New York, New Jersey is Cromwell Plaza Hotel, JFK Airport, New York, 13810135 Avenue. Venue once again is Cromwell Plaza Hotel, JFK Airport, New York, 13810135 Avenue. Telephone number to call is 718-530-116. But for further information, those of you in New Jersey and New York, you call the New York State Coordinator, Mazi David Ezekwesile, on 832-254-5640. Once again, Mazi David Ezekwesile on 832-245-5640. Or better still, you can call New Jersey Coordinator Mazi Chijoke Onyechega on 973-545-1732. 2:6. New JC coordinator Mazi Chijoki Onyechiga. You can contact him for further information for those of you who will want to visit our Supreme Leader Mazi Nandioku Kano. You have important questions to ask. You have suggestions to make. You can contact our new JC coordinator Mazi Chijoki on 073-545-1726. The PROO of New Jersey, New York family is Mazi Izuchukwu Okoli. You can contact him on 646-645-8237. PROO of New Jersey, New York family is Mazi Izuchukwu Okoli. You can contact him on 646-645-8237. Come one, come all. Name and where are you calling from? Call on the line.
Are you hearing me, sir?
Please try and speak louder. The world is listening.
Okay, I am Amaleri speaking from Aba. I have an information to give to the Biafrans wherever you are listening to us tonight. It's about what happened at Aba here on Saturday, the bomb planted in Aba. So a friend of mine called me, who always worked with the police, and he told me everything that happened on Saturday. So he said that I should alert everybody because the police has conspired not to let the media within Aba, Motukwel, and in the zoo here to know anything about the bomb issue. They said that if actually the media carries it, that there will be problem in Aba. So the spirit removed the bomb. According to the young man that told me all these stories, he said that a Fulani man came to June in Ekotebeni Road, number one Ekotebeni Road. Are you listening, sir?
Are you telling me or you're telling the world?
I am telling. So then the Fulani man came and he requested the gent of the of that museum, that is their university. So they asked him to go and urinate. So he just went there with his bag and on the wall. So he came out there, undressed himself, put on another cloth with a wig, like a mad person. So on he went outside at the side, by the corner of that building. Then outside the building, so he now on his umbrella scattered the bags as if he's a mad person. So unfortunately to him, and he brought out a laptop, start operating the laptop in order to arm the bomb. Bomb. So along the line, an officer, an intelligent officer, saw the scene. So he couldn't bear it. He just looked around, and then he never saw such a mad person in Aba before. He started looking at him, and he saw the laptop. He now asked, "What is this madman doing with a laptop? Did he just pick the laptop from somebody?" Or so he just came around. He asked him, "Please, who are you? What's your name?" The Fulani man couldn't even respond. He started looking at him. He asked him, "Are you a madman?" He said, "Yes." So the man said, "How can a madman agree that he's a madman? It's unfortunate." So he started asking him, "What is in the laptop? Show me the laptop." He said, he don't want to agree. So the man started raising alarm. So on that very scenario, those that are working in that National Museum keep coming, because mainly most of them are Yorubas that are working there. So they keep coming out. So they started arguing. So that guy, the man now brought out his ID card, that intelligent officer brought out his ID card, and then to show that he's an officer. So they now ask the Fulani man to adhere to the instruction given to him. So the man now added the laptop, looked at the laptop and saw the bomb, how he is now directing the bomb in order to arm the bomb. So the man now told these people that this thing is bomb, that bomb is in this particular building. So they now keep searching and saw where the man planted the bomb. Hello, sir. What? Okay. Now they raised an alarm. So they discovered the bomb, and everybody started running out from there. So they called the DPO that is in charge of
That is Zoo Epileptic Network. Our brother was trying to make us understand that someone, a Fulani herdsman, were found planting bombs somewhere in Aba. But our people must be vigilant. Call on the line, your name, and where are you calling from?
Hello.
Good evening from here, your name, and where are you calling from?
Shalom, Watchmaker. My name is Martin Dubois. They're calling from Aba right now, sir. I hail from Enugu, Nala Unakeze, in Biafra land here. As Onyibe, I thank you very much for what you are doing for Biafras, and I pray that Chukwukitabiana will continue to bless you. Based on the information that our guide is giving to us, we or the way the information is coming, I don't know. Chukwukala will still give him the more time for him to complete that information. But let me pass the Onyibe. Your first lineup of your program this evening between 7 o'clock and 8 o'clock before you go and come back again by 9 o'clock. My brother, based on our medicine, I want to start from that place because don't be annoyed at it. I want to start from that place because there is one idea that said that if you worship the Elohim, your father did not worship. The type of sickness that did not affect your fathers will affect you. Because we abandon our way of worship. That's why it was easier for Yoruba people, for Hausa people, for British people to deceive us and make us to drop our own way of medicine, our own way of life. And they choose their own. Start dressing like them. Many of family today are spending money to make sure that their children know how to speak English. But their children doesn't even know how to speak Igbo. Doesn't know how to speak our different vernaculars. They doesn't know. But they are spending money to make sure that their children go to the higher school to learn how to speak English. Why is this so? We have decided to make our own usual and pick our people's own and make it to be original. That is the thing. Chukwuka Kadewa have created our fathers and give us many things free of charge. But British are thief. If you steal one peanut today, then we kill you in any part of Biafra land. But British people have been stealing our oil. That's why my professional stealing. They have been stealing our crude oil for years. And they are using the money they sell with our crude oil they steal to build cities in their own country. And our people are living in Porto Porto. Niger Delta. If you go to Onyibe, Chukwuka don't have mess on us. All the container they see there, now they are plants container. And all the water plant that is in Onyibe, controlling, if you don't give them money, we never carry any container out of that place and come out. And the container that are there is our own. If a Igbo man in Port of Krika, he become contraband. Our man, at times they will ask you to go and look for money before you clear your container. On the point of going to look for money to come and clear your container, then we carry it free of charge and give to Alahaji. Alahaji will took that container to Kanu. All the so-called politicians are not in it. All they can do is to sell their own children for peanuts to our family. Bomb, even this one, not the one where they discover. Bomb is still coming. Let them keep sleeping. Bomb, uncountable bombs are coming. Let them keep sleeping. I was with our people in Kaduna. I witnessed almost 6-7 liars. None of them know any of those liars. That was killed no less than 3,000 people. But after all, what you are going to hear in the radio Nigeria, Kaduna is there was a placard in one part of Kaduna, and after all, one man was sniped and one shell was burned down. After that, they have dig mass grave and bury our people, really, without the information to our people. The so-called radio of Nigeria are not working for our own betterment, are working for our own destruction. Is going to give you information on what is happening around you. They capitalize on giving information on what is happening in China, what is happening in Singapore, what is happening in Germany, about what is happening in their own house. That is the media of Nigeria, the Zoom media. So our people should wake up and let us use our hands to build ourselves. And they pass information to ourselves by the grace of Chukwuka Kabama. Radio Biafra is the only radio in the whole world you can hear somebody. Say it as it is today. The other ones are hiding the truth from the people, using the lie to confuse people for them to remain that forever, for them to remain deaf and dumb forever. My brother, let us wake up. If you are still sleeping, our medicine, both the medicine where they take care heartburn, which is a heartburn, all those things, even any woman in bed and they say
the woman is breathing. We can't find the medicine in the chemist, but we have the griefs where they stop breathing of the woman. If fully about we cannot recognize it. We capitalize in going to hospitals to pursue the medicine that we build, taking the one that Chikokara has given to us. It's a shame to our people. Let us come back to our people. Let us come back to our roots. Let us come back to original things that Chikokara has blessed us with. Thank you very much, Mazo Onyibe. Thank you very much.
Thank you, my brother. We must continue. And good night from here. I will see how I can get our brother back who was giving us information regarding the bomb issue. Hopefully, he will be able to complete the message he has for our people. We are going home. We understand what they are doing in Biafra land. That is why tonight we make them understand that if they don't stand up and do the needful, that which they fear will certainly come upon them. Can you hear me? Can you hear me? Are you there? Can you hear me? Of course, that is Zoo Epileptic Network. But we are not in a hurry. Can you hear me, brother? We will try to connect with him to enable him give us the accurate information on what is going on, what is actually going on. Because these people are systematically cutting down our numbers, killing our people. And you may pretend now as if you don't know what is happening, but it will get to all of us. Make no mistake about that. It will get to all of us. That thing you fear will come upon you. The only solution is for you to look for IPOB family closer to you and join. Don't let them deceive you. They tell you everything they want to tell you and you believe them. It is too late. Really too late for Nigeria. Really too late for the saboteurs. Really too late for all of them because we are going home. Can you hear me, my brother? Can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you, sir.
Zoo Epileptic Network. You were telling us about the bomb that was planted. Can you go ahead with that information, please?
Okay, sir. Am I coming clear, sir?
Of course, if you are not coming clear, I will not ask you to go ahead.
Okay, sir. This bomb issue led Okon, the one that threatening IPOB, the CP in Abia State, to make a call for all the security apparatus in Abia State 2 days ago. And he caught all of them. He couldn't even give them the details. Even the civil defense, because we are surprised that police call all of them, even the vigilant, telling them that all of them should be vigilant in Abia State, that something strange will happen. So after that, they all left. But today, as I tell you, they just look at the laptop and they saw how they programmed that bomb. According to the police source, they said that bomb, the damage it could have given to people of Aba, from that particular number one Ekotek Beni, which is the National Museum, to the West Station, which is Zuku Aba, to Nigerian Brewery. So that Godoka for Church, which they call the Godoka for Church, so the waterside bridge will collapse. It will get to somewhere else, Azikiwe, direct to Azikiwe Asa. So all those will be affected if that bomb happened to explode. So he now told them that these people are here and they are afraid now. Even them say the police are afraid of what is happening now. And they say that the reason why they don't want all the media in Nigeria to carry it, all the media in Abuja to carry it, is because if they happen to carry it, that they will be cursed. Even the mobile, even among the security operators, that they will start to kill themselves because they are now afraid of each other. Therefore, they just pamper it, and then the anti-bomb squad just came with their two vans and then packed, take that. That bomb and the Fulani guy. And they said that the order is from above not to touch that young man and not to expose it so that the public people will know. But now they say that we should be telling people in the street, in the church and every other place not to, just to be careful, because these people are here already. But they don't want their zoo papers and the radio and television to carry it. So this is what they are doing here in our land. So we are not safe here in Aba. People may think these people are coming, but they are here already. And even you want that if we see somebody that we never see before, dressing like a mad person or somebody that is insane or whatever, that we have to interrogate that, because these people are up to something. So I want to use this opportunity to tell the world and the Biafrans at large, our others. Okay, sir. That is just the information I want to give to all of us tonight, so that we have to be careful. These people are here with us. And if we think that they are coming from the north, they are here already. So in as much as we expose all these their crimes, they will have no other choice other than to retreat back. So our people should be careful. Thank you. I remain Amaleri from Aba. Thank you, sir.
Yes, thank you very much. I would have asked you one or two questions, but time is not on our side. But that notwithstanding, I begin to wonder, who they put bomb in Aba, we are afraid. Ooh, they arrest our people in Enugu. Ooh, we are panicking. Ooh, they now go to Akwa Ibom, they arrest. Ooh, come to Abo, come to Yurugudundiara, bomb. Who did bomb for Awosa? Is it British government? Melu. I need you to go back to the social media. Go back to the government platform, most especially Nigerian platform. I'm talking to the global community. You will see when they arrest any criminal, any armed robber, any cultist, any bandit, as they call them, from any part of Nigeria, watch them. When media are coming to interview them, you will see them. They must have beaten them till the extent that maybe one eye blind, one leg broken, 3 bullets in the body. They will have dehumanized them before media will come. Go and look at the current Nigerian trophy, Nigerian, which grammar will I use? Nigerian police commando, they called Boko Haram. That very useless Asama was analyzing for you. You see, they will take this rope, they will put it in one chance, and when they draw it, you see, they construct it very well, so they can, after he finish analyzing, he now bring another Boko Haram and say, who are you? The Boko Haram was wearing face cap. Well, propered, but they deceive you with it. And as they say, oh, we used to kill people, we ask for 2 million, we do this. It's RNG country, very fake country. The people who created Nigeria should be ashamed of themselves. The people who support one Nigeria should be ashamed of themselves. The people who say in territorial integrity and integrity, all of you should be ashamed of. It doesn't matter who you are. Are you not ashamed of yourself? Oh, we are British government. We want to protect our one Nigeria. What do you call one Nigeria? Evil. But then I sign off from here. Maybe I take this last caller and then we'll sign off from here. Can you hear me, caller on the line? Oh, hey, Biafra, I will advise you to move away from your radio set. Turn down the volume of your radio set, move away from the radio set, or I will cut you off. I'm not smiling.
Okay. I want to thank my dear friends all over the world. I want to thank
your radio is distracting you. Your radio is distracting you. Turn down your radio, move away from there, or I cut you off. If I they give you order now, say, move, we are in the war front. Is it how you're going to obey the order?
Okay, Onyibe. It's fine now.
Better.
Okay. I want to thank my dear friends all over the world. I want to thank our leader, Maze Nanekano, the fire of the wilderness, Okuna Bosa. He's now burning the zoo. The zoo are coming to be the ashes.
And also, I want to thank the Mazin Uchomefo. I want to thank all of you. And you, George Onyibe, you are the bulldozer of the Biafrans. You carry all the Yoruba trees the way I fight. So I want to thank all the RQB all over the world. And I want to thank all in the Nigerian, the Zulu country, Biafra land, who are receiving the bullet. So, my brother, I just want to talk to the whole world. Let my people, even broad and the home, to be very calm. Be watchful what is going to happen to this planet people. All this pit in the dig, they will fall inside that pit. All this whole planet is digging, they must fall inside the pit. Because years back, there was a word saying that in time to come, the northerners will push this south. But at the last, the south will push this northerners to the desert. This is what is going to happen this time around. They cannot move about this thing. So I want to tell my people all over the world, IPOP, I thank every all of you, just be calm and be watchful what is going to happen to this particularly the Flanish. They are digging the hole. All of them will fall inside the hole. So the world says, time is coming that north will push the south. But at last, south will push the north to the desert. This is a particular time where they cannot see any green pasture. They cannot see any green tree. But what they will see, that place is only sandy soil. So my people, I want to inform my people about the world that Mazen Nande Kano is the leader of this particular project. It's God's project. And then Nande Kano sits on the feet of Thomas Umunakwe Aguirusi to restore the Biafra. And the George and the Uchimefo sit on the feet of to actualize this Biafra state. And do you, George Onyibe, sit on the seat of Chukwu Makaduna Nzogu to restore this Biafra, whether they like it or not? Nobody on earth can subdue you people because it's God's sender. Now, our people is crying. Our calm Christian people is crying. Or unless people is crying. But in time goes on, they will see what they do for themselves because they prescribe IPOP and they call us terrorists. Nobody is talking for us. We're only talking for us because God has sent us to do the needful. So I hereby to tell my people all over the world, people in the restaurant, people in the Biafra land, that let them keep calm. This thing that see, they will not see it time to come. What God said in this Exodus chapter 14, 13 to 14. All this thing we see, all these vandals we see, all these people we see, we shall see them no more. So I want to tell my people all over the world that don't call that all this thing, all this struggle must be actualized. Biafra must see. God says about it. So I want to thank my people. I am from Omonachi, Nachi Crusader, I'm Samuel Ezakutobodo. I want to thank my coordinator, Marie Odera E. And I want to thank my deputy coordinator, Peter O. We are from Nachi Crusader. And I want to thank our elder, Akuwelno. So, George Onyibe, I want to take all these things to know that the world will be at large. All this, what it happened to us, they will see the calamity. There's no problem.
Thank you very much.
I want to urge all my people, just be very watchful, very careful. When you see somebody you don't know,
thank you.
You have to watch that person very well.
Thank
so my
you.
People, I'm talking this to feed you.
Thank
and
you.
What I've said that thank is, you. God has said thank that the dam must be restored. George, Onyibe, listen. I want you to read this Bible to tell the world what God has said.
Thank you, my brother. Thank you, my brother. Our time is up. Our time is up.
In the 3, 5, 6, 7, 8, I want you to read to the world. Let them hear what God has said. That he said that, behold.
Thank you very much. Good night from here as I'm signing off. And I will say, God bless you. God be with you. Biafra restoration is all we want. Every other thing will take its rightful place at the right time. May God be with us in Chukwuka Abiyama's name. Good night as I sign off from here. You see, you see, you see.
Kaije, kunitenu kaije. Kaije, kunitenu kaije. Kaije, kunitenu kaije.
Eya,
kaije,
eya,
kunitenu
kaije.
And if I jump any soldier, he go hear I go. Say you know, I got a juku rocket yo. Oh na, you got a gun, I got a rocket yo. Oh na na,
I hear some babu a rumble. Come up Biafra, I bad on you. We be the true blood of Israel. They be the bloody Philistines. So we go take them one by one, one, and they go run, 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 run. We be always standing in a zoo. And you go in Mary, yeah.
No negotiation, yo. Everybody, let's stand up. Attention you, no violence, no resolution you, to hell with amalgamation you, fighting for our right thing, brother is not a crime, therefore it's our right thing, make gonna give us a Biafra,
we are Biafra, lovers of freedom, we a nation, no contemplation. Pull the trigger, shoot down the weapon. Shake that, give me the fighters, machine gun. No more Nigeria, no more Sioux soldier for my everyone.
Okereke, okereke, at the best fire, we are the Abi okereke. The lock up team, I'm the carry, they feel like okereke. Anything I'm ready, they go must stop us okereke. We no want negotiation, we want a bakeleke. Ah, shakeleke, ah, obikeleke. Ah, we want to spara, fukwara, fukwara, usakeleke. No castigation, Biafra foundation. My people let us go.
Papa Godi, I come back again. Original Biafra. Me a see me a blessing land me a want. A Babylon, them a wanna push on that. Almighty Jah, their children them a cry. Plenty men every day them a die. A wicked nation, them a know they try. I get a cross room, me a know they lie.
Egala iso kundi bo kaite. Ibi bio iwele bu mu Biafra. Anang ijobu bu mu chukwa yama. David Obota come together.
Yeah, I got pair nail one day, I walk and whining. You when they were men, my god, the people are crying. Care you knew me. Oh, the gonna move me strong man, shoot stand, man, no need me to jet. Whoever is a go egala, yana one day in your we ain't scared of war. I got go behind a coma. Oh ha, ho ha. We are coming for our rights, that's why we the fight. Right.
As a real Biafra, nephew, me boy. I'm gonna shine, yeah, fella play, I'm in back, in the good, the power to the good. Send up a sign, one catch you. Boom, 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 run, 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 give an embassy. Time for peace no more. This is time for war.
And this is when game. Come on, Biafra. Make we the go. Take the pass. Make we the go. Say Nigeria, make the love you. And I know you loyal. Let's go. All your mask just set. Let's go. The number. Unu na bro. Unu na bro. All we need now go to you.
Liver, yeah. Very soon, soon, man, I got no dia. Opa vum vum, I got man, I and I wish into na hair, so like one in the call on the bonandia was a ha. Bonda she, is in well and wire. Guarda, I am one is in well and wire. On the woman, woman, no, never made a lepum de buhe, woman, them de be.
Oh, like I got young, for love, the Joe Republic. Me are a stammer, I come back, a belebe. I'm a supplement, when we turn the microphone, no one will be annulled. Better than myself, tell them. man no pause for me man up your paper. In a big to I may want to IJ.
Kanga nuo. My body don't the hurt you. As if we win it, we move. If you put it, I shoot aside you. Mga bagi ha ha. Mga dukwa bi chon chon chon. Cause I'm a fool, girl, from the man.
Silence. Welcome.